Hi, I'm Lucy, your narrator. Thanks for joining me for another video, and if this is your first time here, a very warm welcome to you. Before we get started, please kindly take a moment right now and click that subscribe button and notification bell so you can be alerted of every time I upload a new video. And also please watch this video to the end to see the preview trailer and a couple of behind the scenes photos. Life with Father is a comedy and family movie. It was released in the USA in 1947 and it stars Irene Dunn and William Powell. And some of the co-stars were Elisabeth Taylor, Edmund Gwenn, Zasu Pitts, Jimmy Lydon, Emma Dunn, Moroni Olsen, Elisabeth Risdon, Johnny Calkins, Martin Milner, Monte Blue, Mary Field, Queenie Leonard, and Clara Blandick. This movie was nominated for 4 Oscars. The movie is about a straight-laced turn-of-the-century father who presides over a family of boys and the mother who really rules the roost. Warner Brothers paid $500,000 for the screen rights, plus 50% of the profits. A record amount for a movie at that time. Clarence Day Sr.'s father, Benjamin Day, founded the New York Sun newspaper in 1833. The premiere was on August 14, 1947, in Skowhegan, Maine, where the play had its initial performance 8 years before. The stage play ran for 3,224 performances, holding the record for the longest non-musical run on Broadway. The play was based on Clarence Day's book. And Mary Pickford made several screen tests for the role of Vinnie, but the studio worried about her box office popularity after a 13-year absence from the screen. In the end, director Michael Cortez vetoed her as he preferred Irene Dunn. Before filming began, the cast was taken to Perk Wetmore's salon on a Sunday morning to have their hair dyed red. When it was time to rinse the dye, the beauticians discovered that the water had been turned off for the entire block because the street was being repaired. Because dyes were so strong then, leaving them on could have caused the cast to lose their hair. Luckily, someone suggested diluting the dye with cold cream. Of the boys in the Day family, only Martin Milner was a natural redhead. Playwrights Howard Lindsay and Russell Crowe and Clarence Day's widow were on the set and given veto power on all aspects of this movie. According to author David Cicciaretti, Mrs. Day approved Irene Dunn's characterization and even lent some jewelry that belonged to the real Vinnie. The department store mentioned in this movie, McCreary's, opened in 1868 as the James McCreary and Company Dry Goods Emporium, located at the corner of 11th Street and Broadway. McCreary opened a second store in 1894 and sold the building, but continued the lease on the lower floors for retail space until 1902. The upper floors were eventually converted into a leather goods factory. The building was heavily damaged by a fire in 1971, and in 1974, the conversion of the building into apartments was completed. The structure is now known as the Cast Iron Building in reference to the original construction of the facade. And other than the color scenes and leathernecking in 1930, this is Irene Dunn's only movie in color. And in later years, Irene Dunn admitted that she hated playing the part of Vinnie, which she considered to be rattle-brained. Director Michael Cortez repeatedly pleaded with her to join the cast until she ultimately consented. If she didn't, the part would have gone to the retired Mary Pickford, who saw the part as a comeback and actively campaigned for the role.
This is Bond. Kind, gentle, sweet, soft-spoken.
Oh, Gad! I won't have it! I won't have it! I will not have my life arranged for me. I bought this house for my own comfort. I will not submit myself to this indignity.
Yes, that's Father. He knows everything about everything. Except Mother.
Now that I have this, you needn't buy me any more rings.
Well, if you don't want any more.
What I'd really like now is a nice diamond necklace.
And here's the rest of the family. Father didn't believe in girls.
Do you know what happened at Dora Wakefield's party for Mary last night? We were playing musical chairs and some girl sat down suddenly right in my lap where I jumped up so fast she almost got hurt. She was sitting on Father's trousers.
Anything wrong with my ticket when I get there? You can fix it up. Everybody loves you so much, I'm sure God must too.
I'll do my best, Claire. It wouldn't be heaven without you.
If you're there, Vinny, I'll manage to get in some way, even if I have to climb the fence. That's all, thank you.
Sir, before I can let any girl go from this establishment, I must know the character of the home in which she will be employed.
Madam, I am the character of my home.
If you like that one, we've got a lot more. Hotter than your morning coffee.
Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, I would greatly appreciate it if you would please kindly give me a like, comment below, share with others, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell to be alerted of every time I upload a new video. Please come back to see the next one. Until then, bye for now, and be blessed.